Sarah Knox, head of robotics developer Kronstadt Industries. A visionary inventor and technological innovator, Robert Knox has spearheaded Kronstadt Industries to the bleeding edge of technological development. His equally brilliant daughter, Sierra, is not only a financial wizard, but also a fiercely competitive race car driver with a fiery temper to match. Kronstadt enjoys enormous popularity with global consumers. However, few are aware that the company is also one of the world's leading suppliers of next-gen military tech. Last year, despotic ruler Jin Po employed prototype Kronstadt drones against peaceful civilian protesters in the now infamous Tungyan Valley incident. And although it has yet to be proven, there is little doubt that the Knoxes personally brokered the deal, making them complicit in a war crime. It is unclear why the Knoxes would betray their masters, but likely the fear of being next on the Shadow Client's hit list has pressured them to cut a deal with the enemy. Undoubtedly, with Kronstadt Industries on their side, the militia will increase their attacks tenfold, and so our contract obligates us to retire Robert and Sierra Knox and contain the damage they may inflict on Providence. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Miami, 47. The innovation race is on its last day, and it is down to the wire. Thousands of eager fans are gathered for the final laps of this unexpectedly close race. Sierra Knox is expertly piloting her red Kronstadt car. Her father, Robert Knox, roams the nearby expo building where Kronstadt is showcasing its new prototype car. The Kronstadt RK Mark III has seen fierce competition from the Chinese Kowloon Heavy Industries' new racer. Moses Lee, CEO of Kowloon, has taken a dominant lead and looks invincible. Sierra Knox will need to risk it all if she wants to win for the third year in a row. The stakes are as high as they can get.
Why not? Oh my god, why not?
Listen, my boss at the game.
Exactly.
See that red car, 47? That's the Kronstadt race car with Sierra Knox behind the wheel. We have placed your requested equipment in a red van in the Expo car park. Pick it up at your leisure.
Can you say that again, please?
Slow down.
Well done.
Anybody got some?
Yeah, thanks. Doctor gave me some sort of vitamin hydration that's normally reserved for the driver. Fixed me right up.
What, like doping?
No, it's for after the racing's done. Although it did kind of look like the Tour de France in there. What with all the syringes and IV stands. I think Sierra Knox had an appointment in there as well. I didn't meet her, though.
Shame. I hear she's fun to be around.
It's me. Oh, me and Elle. Ready to meet up with Sierra Knox
over at the hotel. Yeah, after the race. Just got to pick up the documents from my van, but, I had to knock out a guy and steal his flamingo outfit. Now I can't find my car keys.
Yeah, I know it's dumb. I think I lost them in the scuffle, but the real mascot is still over there. If I don't get them, I've got no evidence.
Heads up, 47. Word around the Kronstadt camp is that one of the mechanics has quit in protest. I suggest you offer your services. A spot on the pit crew would give you hands-on access to Sierra Knox's car.
I am good at this. Flip it.
Beyond fixing.
Day.
That's one of the Kronstadt mechanics, but he's away from the pit. I wonder what he's up to.
Thank you. Done your duty. Now, please step back. Let me do mine.
Not a problem. Listen, mister, I don't care about your problems, all right? I made it clear this morning that if things didn't change, I'd be off to Kronstadt team. Half an hour later, I have to listen to Nox berate my skills as a mechanic because the roll cage interferes with the radio signals from Sierra's suit. No more. I'm done.
Yes, so how do you
I know you're a man
today?
Short now,
well,
and no,
good.
I don't give a rat's ass about it. I'll tell you what, you double my salary for the entire week, and I'll come back in case Sierra decides to use that last pit stop.
Hey, please look where you're going.
Well, if you decide otherwise, I'll be down by the paddock. Best of luck, Grace.
Excellently done, 47.
Please get up, please. Thank you.